This video shows how to graft an orange tree using the T-budding technique. The T-bud is commonly used for grafting orange trees. It is easy and it gives a high success rate. It works well for grafting new fruit trees. I will be grafting to this inexpensive orange tree that I bought locally at a reputable nursery. It is a common variety that I already have, but the tree has a suitable rootstock. The soil in the small original container would dry out too quickly, so I repot the tree. I will be grafting an heirloom Italian mandarin orange variety called Ivana Tardivo. In order to achieve a successful graft and also to avoid spreading disease, I sterilize my grafting tools with a 1.5% concentration of chlorine bleach. This is the original graft that I will be replacing with Ivana Tardivo. I will be grafting to the rootstock slightly below the original graft. First, I remove the leaves and thorns from the rootstock. I cut an upside-down T into the rootstock. An upright T will also work. The advantage of an upside-down T is that it can help to keep water out. This may produce better results in a rainy area. Next, I peel the bark back with the bark lifter on my grafting knife to prepare the rootstock to receive the bud. T-budding must be performed during a time of year when the tree is actively growing, allowing the bark to be peeled back. I slice underneath to cut the bud. The back of the bud has wood attached. The wood does not need to be removed. It is important to avoid touching the cut surfaces of the bud. It is often possible to hold the bud by the petiole where the leaf was attached. Since the petiole has fallen off, I pick up the bud with my knife. Next, I insert the bud under the bark. I cut off the bottom of the bud piece that was sticking out. Next, I wrap the bud tightly with vinyl tape, starting below the bud and wrapping up. My step-by-step article at fruitmentor.com/graftingorangetrees has more information on wrapping material. In order to improve my chances of success, I will graft a second bud to the rootstock. This way I will succeed even if one of the bud grafts fails. Citrus cuttings have the potential to spread tree-killing diseases. It is often not apparent when a tree is infected with a fatal disease. This makes the source of citrus budwood for grafting very important. In California, where I live, we now have both exotic diseases that kill citrus trees and also the insects that spread the diseases. The situation is so severe that it is now against the law in California to graft with backyard citrus cuttings. Hobbyists in California now instead order their budwood at a nominal cost from the Citrus Clonal Protection Program, or CCPP, a program that exists to provide disease-free budwood for the grafting of citrus trees. I've made a video that shows how to set up an account and order citrus budwood. You can click here or visit the link below. The CCPP will ship budwood anywhere in the world where the local laws allow it. Many citrus-growing regions where it is not allowed have their own disease-free citrus budwood programs. Information on other programs is included in the ordering video. Whenever I graft a tree, I make a label with the variety name and the date. After the grafts are finished, I move the tree to a shady area for a 3-week healing period. After the healing period, I unwrap the grafts. Both buds are still green, an indication of success. According to apical dominance, natural hormones from buds higher in the tree will discourage the growth of the grafted buds. To force the grafted buds to grow, I make a cut halfway through the rootstock and push the top over so that it is lower than the grafted buds. The time lapse shows 5 weeks of growth. After a bit more growth, I remove the top of the rootstock and stake the tree. In order to encourage branching, I again break apical dominance by pinching off the terminal buds. Using tested disease-free budwood will keep deadly diseases from spreading into your yard via infected budwood. However, in locations where deadly diseases and the insects that spread them are present, a home-propagated tree is still vulnerable to infection by insects. For this reason, it is important to keep home-propagated citrus trees at home in these locations. For example, at the moment in California, Texas, and Arizona, the movement of a home-propagated citrus tree could lead to a devastating outbreak of the tree-killing Huanglongbing disease in a new location. Even a commercially propagated tree is vulnerable after a few months at home because the insecticides applied by the production nursery are washed away when the plant is watered. I've made this video to save citrus trees all over the world from deadly diseases. You can help by giving this video a thumbs up, by sharing it, and by subscribing to this YouTube channel. Also, be sure to watch my other videos. My complimentary ebook with tips to help you succeed may be downloaded at fruitmentor.com/graftingtips. I hope that you have enjoyed this video and have found it helpful. If you have any questions, please ask below in the comments.